Hey, a few days ago I recorded a video for the students in one of the Russian universities. You can find it on my channel, it's in Russian. And I made a few points there, like a few suggestions for students of what they should be looking for in their career in order to make this career, first during the staying in the university and after that. And I mentioned, aside from some other points, that now it's important to be focused in our technical skills. So comparing to being a programmer 20 years ago, 30 years ago, now it's more important to be a very specific programmer, not just a programmer, not even just a Java programmer, but a programmer focused on very specific technology, a very specific framework, very specific set of problems to which this programmer knows how to solve. And that comparing to 20 years ago is a huge difference, because I said that in that presentation that a long time ago, the programming as a discipline, computer science, was quite new, and we didn't know so many things that introducing object-oriented programming was a breakthrough, or introducing functional programming was a breakthrough, or introducing, let's say, web framework. Wow, it was a breakthrough. So we didn't know how to design web applications, and then a few people came out and said, we have a framework for you, so now you design it this way. And many people said, wow. Or introducing design patterns, for example, like singleton. People were using some solutions, and then some authors said that we suggest to use singletons, something like that. So that was easier. I'm not saying it was different. Okay, I'm not saying easier, but that was a different story a long time ago, because the field was empty. The field had basically no solutions at that time, and that's why any solution was a breakthrough. Now the situation is different. Now we have so many solutions already, and so many topics are already covered on this computer science field that in order to say something new on a higher level, like a new programming paradigm, like we have object-oriented, functional, logical programming, and then I show up and say, I invent the new programming paradigm. That's super difficult, and your chances of success are very low. And I got so many comments there on this video that people were saying, no, we don't think so. We think that the fundamental education is important, and being a jack of all trades, as they say, is very important. So knowing different paradigms, knowing different languages, knowing different methods of programming and programming frameworks, it's so important because you become a specialist who can work, who can solve many problems, and who can work in so many situations and in so many companies, so many projects. This is true. I'm answering to these questions, and this is true. You definitely will become, if you know many things, if you know many technologies, then you will definitely become someone who can work in many projects, and in different places. But how much you're going to earn, how much they're going to pay you, that's a different question. I think that they will pay you way less comparing to the situation where you are a niche specialist who knows something very well comparing to others who don't know so much in this specific area. And again, I may sound like a broken record about open source, but look at the open source. Try to go to GitHub and create something large, like a new programming language or the new web framework. And you see how many stars you're going to get there. You see how big is going to be the community around you. Not so big. Because those solutions already exist. And it's difficult to be unique. It's difficult to show that you are doing something new. And novelty is, I think, one of the key success factors for open source. But if you do something small, if you solve the problem in a very small place where it seems like some problems are solved, but you pick one which nobody solved before, and then you create a library there which presents this solution as a unique something. Then you look at what happens. You look how many stars, how many followers, how big is going to be the community quite fast, because people will see that you dig deeper and you suggest something that nobody suggested before. So open source is kind of a demonstration, it's kind of proof to my point. You will see it in your career if you are a student, and down the road, at your career, you will see what will happen. And I'm sure that in 5-10 years, niche specialists, people who know a lot in a very small domain, they will be valued much more than as they call jacks of all trades, like people who know many programming languages and can solve many different problems. So I think open source is a good demonstration of that. I know it by myself. So I know that my products, which are for everybody, for everything, they are not, I actually didn't have much experience of doing that stuff, like which solves like big problems and huge problems. I don't have much experience in that. But I know that my products, which are very small and which solve very specific, unique problems, they get more stars. And stars are the indicator of success on GitHub. You know that. So think about this. Thanks for listening. And don't forget to watch that presentation, that lecture I gave just a few days ago. It's in Russian. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.